Hey y'all, Bridget Bartlett here with My Vision Agency, and today I want to show you how you can get AI to respond to the comments on your Facebook post. Now you can see that I have my Facebook post here. I've actually boosted this, and if I click on the comments, you'll see when I scroll down, I'm actually automatically responding to everyone who has commented on my post. And you can see here I've used Marie's name in the response, and I'm telling her, thank you for the comment. I'd love to invite you to the free community. We offer live training and coaching 4 days a week to help you master the 4-hour workday strategy. You can see this person posted good morning and the AI responded. And you can see they responded again and the AI did not respond to that. And that's because we have the ability to choose to respond only to the top level comment because we certainly would not want to respond with this again. So there's different ways that you can set it up. This makes it super easy. Now you also have the ability to have them comment a keyword and then you can respond to that and then send them a DM. So I'm going to go through both of those strategies today with you so that you can get more engagement on your Facebook posts. If you are interested in this training to learn how to effectively boost your Facebook post, you can go to myvisionagency.com. You can click here to sign up for our free community. Now, I am going to use HighLevel for the tool to get the AI to respond. So if you're not a HighLevel customer yet, you can actually sign up here using my affiliate link and you'll get a free membership in our software reseller program. If you are already a HighLevel customer and you'd like to join our program, you can use this option here to join starting at just $97 a month. Now inside of HighLevel, you'll see that we have the workflow here and the trigger of the workflow is when someone comments on a post. So this is my real live workflow that I'm using here for that post. And you'll see that I've chosen my page and it knows what page because you've connected your Facebook account to your HighLevel account. Now you also see we can choose the post type. So you can choose whether it's custom or published. And then we have the post is, so I'm choosing the exact post because I don't want it to respond the same thing on every single post. So I want to make this really specific. So I'm choosing that exact post. I can also filter this more if I need to, but I want to definitely toggle on this first level comment. I don't want to be responding if someone replies with the same comment that I did in the first comment. That's super spammy and none of us really like that. So I'm going to go ahead and close that out. Now the next step here is the AI. So we have the function in our workflows to choose the GPT powered by OpenAI. We could choose the model here that we want to use. And then you do have some actions here. You can choose a custom action, which is what I'm using. You can also use this to translate the content, to summarize the content, and even analyze the sentiment here. Now I can enable the chat if I did want my AI to keep responding and it would actually remember the history of the chat. So that's really cool. And then we have our prompt here and I want to show you my real life prompt that I'm using. You are Bridget Bartlett, founder and CEO of My Vision Agency. You help entrepreneurs build a profitable business using the 4-hour workday strategy with AI tools and automation. Respond to this Facebook comment in your authentic, helpful voice. So we have the comment here, and then we have the custom value that it's going to pull in from the comment. And you can choose that here by going to custom values, go to Facebook comments, and then you have the comment body. When you click there, that puts this custom value there. So whatever that comment was, it's going to replace this custom value with that comment. Now we can also use the commenter's first name. As soon as it comes into HighLevel, their name that's attached to their Facebook profile will automatically be there. So we can use that for their first name and make it a little bit more personal. Now we have some response rules here. So if the comment is negative or critical, thank them personally for their engagement and explain how their comment helps the post reach more people. Stay positive and professional. This is your brand. The next step is if the comment is positive or neutral, thank them personally and invite them to join your free community at myvisionagency.com, where you provide live training and coaching 4 days a week. End with, I'll see you inside. Always start with, hey, contact first name to personalize the response. Write as Bridget Bartlett. Use I statements in your personal voice. Focus on the four-hour workday strategy and community benefits. Keep responses under 280 characters. Use a friendly entrepreneurial tone that reflects your expertise. Include appropriate emojis and be helpful and authentic to your brand. So these are all of the instructions that I'm giving AI so that it can generate the response. Now, I do have some advanced options here where I can choose the temperature. It needs to be between 0 and 1. And they explain to you 0.8 will make the output more random. 0.2 will make it more focused and deterministic. So let's just keep it at 2 and we'll go ahead and save the action. So now if you're following along here, every time someone has commented on this specific post, it's going to go into our AI tool. It's going to read the instructions and generate a response, but we have to tell it to respond. So that next step is reply and comments. And you can see that this does work for Facebook and Instagram, but it does need to be a business page. Any type of automation that you're doing needs to be a business page. So what we want to do here is we will actually want to take that response that the AI has generated. And we can simply do that by going to the custom values here, and you'll go to GPT. And you'll see the GPT response here. When you click that, it's going to paste in this custom value. Now here, you can also choose to like the comment that you're responding to. So you can toggle that on there. And then of course, we want to save the action and then save your workflow. Make sure to also publish so that it actually starts working. Now, an alternative to that is if my post said, comment below the word boost, and I will send you the training. So we have an extra filter here. It's the same trigger that we had before, except this time we're using contains phrase boost. Now I choose contain phrase instead of exact match because sometimes people will add extra words instead of just the keyword. So if they posted, I'm so interested in the boost training, then I still want this to trigger. Just because they put extra words doesn't mean they didn't actually comment boost. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose contains phrase and then we'll add boost there. And then like before, I only want to respond to the first level comments. So I'm gonna toggle this on there and then save the trigger. Now the next step is our GPT powered by OpenAI again. And this is a custom action. And you can see here, the prompt is just a little bit different. So the prompt is, you are Bridget Bartlett, founder and CEO of My Vision Agency. Someone just commented boost on your Facebook post, showing they want access to your training on boosting Facebook posts effectively. Create a unique personalized response that directs them to check their DMs. So we have the comment here. And again, it's pulling in that custom value from the Facebook comment here. And then again, we have the first name of the contact. So the rules here always start with, hey, contact first name for personalization. Acknowledge they commented boost and thank them for their interest. Let them know you've sent them a DM with the training link on boosting Facebook posts effectively. Vary your language each time. Use different phrases like check your messages, sent you a DM, look for my message, etc. Now, this is really important because if you've used any other tool that does not use AI, it will automatically respond with a static message. And that really seems spammy and your account can actually get restricted because Facebook will even acknowledge it as being spammy. So you really want to make sure that you're using AI to spin this response so that it is different every time or most times. The next step here, keep responses under 150 characters for better engagement. Use 1 to 2 relevant emojis. Write in your authentic, friendly voice as Bridget. Make each response feel natural and conversational, not robotic. And then it says, generate a unique response now. Again, we have the temperature here that we can adjust. We'll go ahead and save action. And then we have the respond with the comment. So same here, we're going to now respond with whatever this generated. And we want to pull that in by going to the custom value, going to GPT, and then choosing that custom value there. We can also choose again to like the comments when we're responding. Now, the next step here, we're going to use the Facebook Interactive Messenger because we're not responding automatically in the comment. We are actually telling them in the comment, hey, I just sent you the link to the training. Check your DMs. So now we're sending them a private message in Facebook. And when we send them that private message, here's the response that I've generated. Hey, contact first name. Thanks for commenting boost on my post. Here's your exclusive training to my training on boosting Facebook posts effectively. Here's the free training access. And then here is the direct link once they have gained access. And then it says, important, make sure to register at the first link before accessing the training. And then it says, I go live with new training 4 days a week, so you'll have access to ongoing valuable content. See you inside. Now, if I wanted to, I could add extra buttons here. I actually contemplated whether I wanted to add the free community button and say step one, and then direct them to this post and say step two. And you certainly can do that. I just added it to this message here. And then you also have quick replies. So you can add up to 13 quick replies that contacts can select to send as messages in Facebook Messenger. And then you can choose the wait step. So for any messenger action, we need to add a wait time. And if no input is received by that time, we will move them into the default next step. By default, a wait time of 1 minute is added, which is editable. If no button is selected, contact will go to the default timeout branch. Okay, so we'll just keep that as wait time 1 minute because we actually don't have anything else going out to them at this point in this workflow. Now, I hope you guys have seen how easy this is to use HighLevel to automatically respond to your Facebook comments. If you're boosting a post, this is really effective at getting engagement with your content. So I definitely encourage you, if you do not have a HighLevel account yet, go to myvisionagency.com, click here to create a HighLevel account. If you're already a HighLevel user, you can actually click here. You'll get access to our reseller program where we have live coaching 5 days a week. You also get access to resell our AI ads manager. You also get access to our other tools and resources that we provide. If you're not quite sure or you're not ready to sign up for HighLevel, you can actually click here to join our free community. You can check out that training that I talked about today and then all of the other training that I have in the community as well. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I look forward to working with you in open office hours. Go make your vision a reality. Bye.